Now, of course, those awards are all well and good, but let's check out now who wowed in front of the world's paparazzi. Brian Dowling and stylist Angela Scanlon join us now to see who came out on top in the style stakes. But before we dish out our very own fashion awards, let's take a look back at some of the red carpet highlights. Love is like a stubborn youth. Right, we're going to crack on with Sandra Bullock in Bottega Veneta. What did you make of this purple number?
I like the top half, the bottom half a bit too see-through. Quality street rapper, and she was a little pale. She could have been slightly browner.
I thought so too. They kind of go for that alabaster skin,
yes,
don't they?
Spray it on, spray it on.
What was your take, Angela?
I have to disagree about the tan. I thought her skin looked gorgeous, but again, agreement. I loved the top, but the bottom was just a bit wishy-washy. It kind of was a bit shiny. Looked a bit cheap, really.
It did, actually. She would have had her pick of everyone because she was up for the award. She went away with it. That I was kind of surprised she went for this. Nice to see her in colour. You predicted, Angela. Well done. Snaps for you. Drew Barrymore was next, and she wore Atelier Versace. Brian, what did you think?
Absolutely flawless. I love. I quite like the thing at the side. Pop your drink on that later, Drew. Her hair is just simple. Her makeup is flawless. She looks amazing. Beautiful dress, beautiful colour. Love the detail. Not the many accessories, because the dress kind of speaks for itself.
It does.
Yeah, beautiful.
Angela, you predicted that Drew was going to do something to wow us, because last year she had the hair really big bouffant. Do you think she got it right this year?
I think she absolutely nailed it. She was like my best dress, definitely.
Really?
She was beautiful. And again, I said she might go for something that was understated, a bit vintage looking. And I think she did that. Her hair was beautifully simple, gorgeous makeup, a little pop of colour on the lips, and I thought she just looked stunning. Mm-hmm.
Someone else who you predicted correctly was Meryl Streep, who again went for a classic black long sleeve. What did you think about this outfit?
I hoped that she wouldn't go for black. I said, she probably will, but hopefully not. I thought she looked lovely. She looked age appropriate. Yes. A little bit of skin on show, covered the arms, a little belt to kind of make it a little bit fresher looking. Mm. But I mean, she looked great.
And showing a bit of shoulder.
Do you like that? She's one shoulder, sleeve up. Is that deliberate to you?
Probably too much champagne to write out what we're doing. But I think she's, as you said, a very valid, age appropriate.
Yes.
And it's Meryl Streep, and she's amazing. But she looks good. And black is classic.
Okay, well, we're going from black to very bright pink. We have Diane Kruger and Kristen LeCroix. What did you think of
this? My eyes! It's too much, because she's so beautiful.
It was kind of strange that it's changed twice.
Yes.
For her.
And also this thing that's here, and just, no, it's just wrong. Give it back. I don't like it.
Send it back.
What do you think, Angela? Too fussy?
I don't know. I think it's too much. I think the colour is so frothy and girly and candy-ish, and then the froth and the frills were too much. I think if she'd gone for a simpler colour with the froth, she would have got away with
it.
But she's usually sleeker.
And Joshua Jackson, handsome.
Homina.
He makes the dress look better.
Accessories on the night, for sure. Then Mariah Carey had some nice accessories herself. Well, what did you think of her?
I think I know what Mariah Carey got from Father Christmas. I mean, hello? I mean, who or what is that?
So this is the thing, this is a beautiful Herve Léger dress.
Yes.
No one's looking at the dress.
No.
And no amount of Chopard jewellery could take away from the crown jewel.
And
totally.
What tan is she wearing? She's like a statue.
I know, seriously, she's been varnished.
Yeah, it's a nice dress. I think it's a bit cheap. I mean, if she had a pole, the dress would look better. But there's no pole on Joe. So I think it's just a bit OTT.
Yeah, it's totally cheap. She looks cheap.
It's totally cheap.
Quite perfect for the Golden Globes, if you hear what I'm saying. Let's move on to Chloe Sevigny. What did you think of her look?
Okay, I think the dress was beautiful. Look how she works it. I want to know how she does.
That is power posing, isn't it?
You'll see her now. Look.
Pop it.
Dress is beautiful. A little OTT, but I think it works. and she carries it off.
Now, this was Valentino. Did you like it, Angela?
I liked it, and I think, again, Chloe Sevigny is somebody who's always fashion-forward, yeah. And ruffles, nude tones are massive for spring-summer 10, so she's probably on the money in that sense, and I think because she's so statuesque and slim, she can carry off ruffles where the vast majority of people would look...
Like me.
...silly.
No, you would look crazy.
Well, you might look crazy in that dress,
thanks.
But yeah.
Someone who looked very sweet, I thought, on the red carpet was Lea Michele. Now, viewers of TV3's Glee will know her
yes.
well.
Yep.
This is a beautiful Oscar de la Renta dress.
I think
from
it
your
was...
view.
A princess dress and her first Golden Globes. She's obviously making a statement, mm-hmm. and it's so simple but yet beautiful. I like the shape of the top and the way it just flows.
Do you not
she looks so elegant.
You don't think she looks swamped because she's quite petite?
I would think so, and I think for a girl her age, like she's quite young, or yeah. at least we know her as being quite a young character. I think it's a little safety for a young woman.
Well, I think because it's the Golden Globe, she wants to make an impact and wants to make a statement. I think the dress does.
Do you know what? It's kind of like yeah. she needs the column inches because she's a new start.
Exactly.
Meryl Streep doesn't need
doesn't.
It.
So she's showing her shoulder.
Absolutely, yes.
Oh, she's shoulder.
And
sleeve.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, now we do have to give a mention to George Clooney. Fantastic, probably your favourite male on the red carpet. What do you think of his look?
I mean, it's a suit, but it's George Clooney. He's in a bin liner, it's George Clooney. It works. I'm not sure I like the beard.
Well, see, the thing is, he's quite disheveled looking because, of course, he is organising this
raising
massive
funds,
telethon
yes.
for Haiti. Yeah. What did you think? You thought he was looking a bit worn as well.
I thought he looked a little bit tired, but, I mean, he's up all night. He's, you know,
working
on a good cause. Like, George Clooney is a beautiful yeah. man.
Absolutely. Right,
so he's good.
Absolutely, we adore him. Let's just look at pictures of him all afternoon.
Okay.
Tell me, what did you think of the red carpet in general? Hits or misses?
I thought the... hits, majority of clients, but some people got it wrong. There was a lot of colour, but the dresses were all, there was lots of frills, there was lots going on.
Yeah.
On a lot of the dresses.
Yeah.
I thought some of the guys this year pulled it out. Joshua Jackson, George Clooney.
Mm. Yeah, looking great.
Nice suit.
Angela, what did you think?
Cameron Diaz, we saw in the intro, I think looked beautiful in McQueen. Really gorgeous and nice to see a bit of colour, and she's such a hot body anyway, she can carry it off. Mariah Carey, for me, was the biggest clanger.
I think hair, their hair. The hair wasn't OTT this year. Very
no,
simple
it wasn't
hair. Maybe because it was raining.
Oh, of course. Yeah,
hair
of course.
Back,
yeah, we should have mentioned that.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Do you think this will gauge how it goes for Oscars? I mean, they always kind of say that it's more relaxed at the Golden Globes. Do you think they're yeah. going to like really up the glamour now for the Oscars?
I think there's going to be an awful lot of nude tones. I think because of the circumstances, there's a lot of black, so hopefully that will filter out and there's going to be a bit more colour.
Just wondering,
Oscars
what can
time.
Mariah Carey wear to top that outfit? She'll actually wear nothing. She'll be topless. Two Oscars.
Brilliant. And there we shall leave it. Thank you very much,
thank
Brian
very
and
much.
Angela, for joining us in the studio. Now, coming